So I've had a number of people ask me, you know, can I recover my seed phrase if I've lost one or two or three or four or even six of the words, sometimes even 12. So this video is going to look at how to use BTCRecover to recover your seed phrase if you know that you have a couple of words missing from your seed phrase, and especially if you know which words those are. And as always, if you haven't already done so, hit subscribe, and that way you can stay in the loop about future content I make to help you to find your way in the crazy and often hostile environment that is cryptocurrency. So if you find yourself in a situation where you're missing some words and don't know what to do, this guide's going to look at that. Though there are some important notes to start, and that's firstly, don't ignore the security of your recovery environment. I cover this in the previous videos on using BTCRecover. You will need part of your 24-word seed, even if it has errors. For the purposes of this video, I think we should say the realistic limit is really recovering three missing words. Any more than that, and you're talking a recovery that's going to take months and years to do. I will do a future video looking at the realistic limits of using BTCRecover, but if you have, say, less than six words missing, or even if you do have six words missing, it's the kind of thing that isn't realistic today, but could very well become realistic in the next decade or two. So if you've lost like five or six of your words, you know, don't throw the seed phrase away, but also understand that this might be something that will be more doable in the future, even if it's not doable today. And if you're someone who split your 24-word seed in half and has lost 12 of those words, I'm sorry, there is simply no practical recovery option available to you at all. And I find it hard to conceive of a situation where it would even be recoverable at any point in the next century. It simply gets far too complex far too quickly. Like always, for this, you'll need to know at least one address that you had used with this wallet. The setup is the same for all of these videos that I do. You need to set up your environment, you need to download BTCRecover. If you are trying to use it with Litecoin addresses, you'll need to use my more recent fork of BTCRecover, and we'll look at the command line options to run BTCRecover. So don't just double click on it, because it probably won't do what you want. So the first example we have is one where you are trying to use BTCRecover and you've lost the last two words for whatever reason. Okay, so for this first example, we're just going to use this command here, which is basically the same as one I'd used in a previous video looking at using this with Litecoin. But the key thing here is we need to tell it that there are two typos, and we also need to tell it that those two typos we want are big typos. So that means like completely different words, not just looking for one character that's wrong or something like that. So we'll just say we want that to run. We don't have a wallet file. We're just using a standard BIP39 thing. We don't have an XPub key. We're going to use this Litecoin address, and we are going to use this best guess of the mnemonic. So we've replaced the last two words, which are just completely unknown, with a number, and that's just going to tell BTCRecover immediately that is an invalid word. That is an invalid word, so it's going to target the errors there. There we go. Found a result, 30 seconds. So it's correctly identified the last two words. The other example that I'll look at is something which I've had one or two people ask about, and that's essentially where someone is trying to recover a missing word, but they don't know which word. So maybe their word list only has 23 words written on it, because, you know, it might sound odd, but some people use this as a security mechanism to, you know, deliberately leave words out of their seed phrase as sort of like a DIY security kind of thing, but had subsequently lost or forgotten the word that was missing. So the approach here, when there's one word that is missing, so essentially methodically try and work out where the gap would have been. So I've just got the first two steps that you might do for that, and we'll run through it here. So again, the same command we're using before, except this time we had 23 words, so we're only going to worry about one typo and one big typo. So we'll just pop that there, and what we're going to say is we don't have any of these things. We're looking for this Litecoin address, and our first guess is going to be that they had 23 words and that maybe they just left the first one off. So we'll just put that in position one and put the number one there, simply so that you can keep track of it yourself when you're doing this. It'll run through there, it'll exhaust in a couple of seconds and say, nah, seed not found. Bummer. So not to be deterred, we run the command again. This time we've said, well, maybe the word that was missing is in between element and sniff. So we put the number two in there. So we don't have that. We don't have an XPub key. The address we want is this one. And the best guess mnemonic is this. So we'll let that run. And bingo, found it. So again, this seems like an odd example, but this is just for those folk who have created this situation for themselves and are wondering how to get out of it. And as we can see here, even just removing, you know, two or three words from your passphrase is something that can be recovered from, even if it is going to take a bit of manual work for this kind of situation here. Thanks for watching. I hope that was helpful. Hit like if you think that other people would find this video useful, and hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make that helps people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. If you have any questions about this video or a topic that you'd like me to cover, just leave a reply.